Welcome to Better Facebook for Schools e-learning platform CROS SS3. On this subject, this time, this video, we are taking the topic opposition to the gospel. Opposition to the gospel message. In this, we want to consider the opposition against Stephen, opposition, source opposition to the church. Now, opposition in the first place refers to any action, reaction, any behavior that is against a particular thing. That's what opposition is talking about. So, right here, we are talking about all the actions and reactions that we are all against the gospel message. Now, taking Stephen as an example, Stephen was one of the several deacons that were elected to help in the administration, the sharing of food to the early, in the early church, to the women, to the widows. But Stephen was full of the Holy Ghost. Just like other deacons, Stephen was full of the Holy Ghost. He was full of wisdom, he was full of power. He was full of God. So, combining with his normal sharing of food, Stephen started preaching. In the process of preaching, the people he was preaching to discovered that Stephen was so wise, full of wisdom. So, they brought up an argument against, about what he was preaching. After all they did, the set of Jews, it was also the Jews that brought up an argument, his own fellow Jews that brought up an argument against him. After all they tried against Stephen, they could not win Stephen in the argument. He was not really arguing, he was telling them the fact, the wisdom with which he was speaking, they could not understand. So, when they saw that they could not, they now went to motivate a kind of case against him. They brought up an accusation against him. What was the accusation? They said Stephen was cursing God and Moses. So that was what he was saying, and that he said Jesus would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days. So they carried the case straight to the highest court of law those days, which was called the Sanhedrin. When they got to that highest court, Sanhedrin, the Sanhedrin listened to what they said and asked Stephen to defend himself whether what they said was true. Stephen started talking, explaining to them the scriptures, the Bible, from Genesis, how they went to Egypt, Joseph was given birth to Joseph, became one of the patriarchs, Joseph, they were not sold to the Egypt. Later, there was a man, a Pharaoh, that came that was on to Egypt, that does not know the children of Israel, how they were in bondage. You know the story of the children of Israel living in the land of bondage, Egypt to Canaan. In that narrative, everything, let them know. Trace it up to their generation. Everything he said before, he repeated everything again. Now that was what he was talking about. After he had spoken to that extent, he now said something. He said, in all of this journey and movement and stories that he has given, that there have been no period, no age, that the Sanhedrin, the Jews, did not kill the prophet. That their fathers, including them, killed all the prophets that they were sent to deliver them. Even Jesus Christ, that they killed even Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Now, on hearing this, that they killed even Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, they were angry. They were angry that he was saying that they killed Jesus Christ, the Son of God, and that Jesus Christ said he would destroy the temple and raise it up the third day, and that he was accusing or cursing Moses. And then these crimes were criminal crimes that attracted death sentence. So hearing this, and as we are looking at Peter's face was shining like that of an angel. They carried Peter out of the city, stoned Stephen until Stephen died. Meanwhile, while they were stoning Stephen, Peter, they kept their clothes, they put us. While they were still stoning Stephen, rather, they kept all their clothes, those that were stoning Stephen, they kept all their clothes in the custody of a man called Saul. So, Stephen died. Opposition against the church, against the gospel. They didn't want anybody to talk about Jesus Christ. They didn't want anybody to speak about the resurrection of Christ, about salvation, because they were feeling guilty. They killed the child of God, the only Messiah. Now, what about Saul? Let me go to the story of Saul. Think for the book of Acts chapter 6. Saul was a young man. Like I said, whose feet they kept the clothes? They kept their clothes, those that stoned Stephen to death. Now, when it just happened that Stephen died, Stephen was the first martyr, first man, first person to be killed for Jesus Christ, because of Jesus Christ and the gospel. Now, in the day they finished that, it's a record that Saul went to the high priest, collected permission, letter of permission, and then went looking for Christians anywhere. Christians where? Who? Who's a Christian? He went with all the soldiers. The soldiers are good. Anyone you get, you arrest them. Even out of the land, far away countries, looking for them. The intention was to get them, beat the ones they could beat, imprison the ones they could imprison. On this very fateful day, he had collected the letter of permission, was going to Damascus to get the Christians there. And then the letter was to be given to the priest at Damascus, like president of Damascus, to release all the Christians to him, to join him, fish them out, and bring them back to Jerusalem to be imprisoned. He went to arrest them. While he was going on the fateful day, the light shone from heaven. And then he fell from the horse, or camel was riding. And then a voice came from heaven. Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? It is difficult for you to kick a stone. He looked. All that were with him, they heard the voice. But they didn't know what was happening. So that was how Saul fell. I said, who are you, Lord? He said, I am Jesus Christ, who you are persecuting. What would you have me do? Jesus, the Lord told him in that revelation to him on that very afternoon, go to the house. And then he went, they led, immediately became blind. They carried him by the hand, led him to the land, into the city. Thereafter, a man, the Lord revealed to a man called Ananias. Ananias went, laid his hand on him, and then he became full of the Holy Ghost. After 3 days, he was there praying and repenting and changing from all his evil ways. He now realized that what he was doing was wrong. That those people he was going to look for, the Christians, they were doing the real thing. That they, he himself, was doing the wrong thing. So it was that plea for forgiveness. 3 days without food, he was blind also. Then Ananias laid his hand on him, he became born again and full of the Holy Ghost. And then, don't forget, I said he laid his hand, he was blind after seeing the light. After laying the hands on him, Ananias, he recovered, he got his sight. Immediately, Apostle Paul, or rather Saul, who still was now Islam Paul, became an apostle of Jesus Christ. Started preaching, became a Christian himself. So, these are some of the oppositions that have been against the gospel. I discover now that, okay, let's keep that. My time is off. Practice this exercise at home. Please identify some other oppositions against the gospel. They are all up to the present. The headsmen, the book, and all that. You can have a lot from the scriptures, to the present. Identify other oppositions against the scriptures. And then what are the moral lessons from Stephen? Identify the moral lessons from Stephen and Paul's opposition to the church. Till next time we meet on this platform, remain good.